Hello friends, in this video I am going to explain RF MEMS. RF MEMS is full generally stand from radio frequency micro electromechanical system. MEMS element range in size from 1 to 100 micrometer. So generally RF MEMS is one of the emerging area of the MEMS device. Here I am write some component of RF MEMS. First one is variable capacitor, inductors, switches, phase shifters, filters, high quality resonators, antennas, and micro machining transmission lines. So RF MEMS provide component with reduced size and weight, very low loss, low power consumption, wide bandwidth, higher linearity, lower phase noise, better phase stability, and high isolation. So first one, here I am consider RF MEMS capacitor. So these capacitors are of parallel plate capacitors. You can see here two parallels, one is the upper and this one is a lower. So this type of capacitor, a parallel plate capacitor type, here is a bottom plate is fixed. This one you can see here, the bottom, that one. This is the upper part and this one. So bottom plate is fixed and the top plate is suspended at the air gap. Here is suspended for the air gap. This top plate is suspended using the T shape here, like a beam type shape, which supports it for the suspension of the top plate. There, these metal plates are separated by air gap, and the capacitance of this plate can be changed by varying the gap through various type of actuators. It may be electrostatic, electrothermal actuators, piezoelectric actuators. So in first case, the gap is changed by the electrostatic actuators by applying the bias voltage. This can be changed to only change to 1/3 of the gap between the plates, which corresponds to 50% increase of capacitance, the electrostatic actuator based capacitor generally it provides low power consumption. They also provide high activation speed and large deflection capability. But the tuning range in this capacitor is relatively less as compared to electrothermal actuators and piezoelectric actuators. So the tuning limit can be overcome by the electrothermal actuators, where the gap is reduced using the thermal mismatch. So differential thermal temperature are provided between the wide and the narrow strip of the parallel plates. So here you can see here is provide narrow strip and the parallel plate capacitor. In this case, narrow strip wide is more, so they bends down. So next type capacitor gap can be controlled by the piezoelectric actuators. In case of piezoelectric, they provide linear tuning of the capacitor and they provide low driving voltage. So these are the advantages of piezoelectric actuators. When the bias voltage is applied between the controlling pad, so this one is the pad on both sides, you can see here is attached on a bottom plate, is applied between the controlling pads. The piezoelectric actuator move down to dielectric of the top metal plate. It provide our area tuning instead of gap tuning, because there is no limit one of the area tuning, one of the common structure where the resonance frequency is controlled by changing the length of common structure and spring constant. So also it is used for phase shifters. And second one is, here I am going to explain RF MEMS inductors. So RF MEMS inductors, micro machine inductors offer better performance than present CMOS inductors. Generally, it is divided two category: planar inductors and solenoid inductors. RF MEMS inductors, the most important property of RF inductors are the inductance value of quality factor and it is self resonance. Among this quality factor is the most critical parameter. RF MEMS based inductors is solution to that. These are two type. One is a planar inductors and second one is solenoid inductors. The planar inductors could be two types, a spiral and the mandrel in shape. The spiral inductor inductance can be increased by increasing the number of turns. So you can see here is increasing number of turns. So he's increasing. But in case of capacitance between the turn, which reduce the quality factors, they provide low driving voltage. So these are the advantage. Sorry. In the case of mineral type structure, they provide the low inductance value and this problem can be overcome with the help of solenoid inductors, but they are difficult to fabricate due to their 3D geometry. So thank you for this video.